Good morning. So today I want to continue working on the new Snippet Pixie GUI. So let's get to Go land. Right. And we're we're in destruction free mode. That's a good point. I didn't update shortcuts. I should probably quickly do that. I couldn't actually get in and out of this destruction free mode, could I? So the problem is at the moment I've got Snippet Pixie set to control backtick, so that it does that. And unfortunately, this destruction free mode wants to use the same hotkey for that. Now I can either change go and, so it uses a different hotkey for that, or I could update my shortcut for Snippet Pixie, because I've kind of been previous to this install I was using super backtick because I had other clashes on the other OS, more deeper, lower level clashes on that control backtick. I kind of got used to it, and it's kind of nice having super be a like sort of session thing rather than control, which is more of a sort of app thing. So maybe I'll have a switch back to that. Let's do that. Quickly do this. You just have to bear with me for a minute. Yeah. So we've got mod there for that's on the previous install. So what I'll do is I'll take that out. Do this. Okay. Reload config. So now I should be able to do super backtick. Okay. Right. And control backtick should just like put some rubbish in my console. Doesn't do anything. Oh, I've got Go and open, haven't I? Wonder if that'll do. There we go. Aha. View mode. Excellent. Okay. Smart. Okay. Right. Okay, so let's bring up console and where we were at last time. So we got this UI, which is kind of very, I was just basically mucking about with CSS, seeing how it works, whether it would be usable as a app. And clearly it's not to everyone's taste, but it is to my taste. It's what I use. I use Nord color scheme. And while I'm just fleshing out the app and the way it works, I'm sure I could use this, use tokens for the colors and all this kind of stuff. And then in the future, have some sort of way of just swapping out what the theme is, maybe make some more sort of agnostic ones, things that are a bit closer to your average desktop environment. So I think I'll play with this from now on. So what I've got to do is work out how I want this window to work. So my goal at the moment is to get a settings app up and running. So this is where you can actually add snippets with their abbreviation and body, and then manage them. So delete them, rename the abbreviation, update the snippet body, and potentially handle any other little settings that might come along as well. Maybe in the future we'll override, say, the date format that gets displayed by default and things like that. If it doesn't quite fit with your desktop environment, you'd prefer maybe something else by default, even though you can use a hard-coded format anyway if you want. And then there's things like, are you doing auto-expanding, which we can't get working at the moment, but you know, hopefully in the future we'll. And potentially the hotkey and things like that. So there's also then the UI for when you do search and paste. So that's when I do that, and you can search for something and then pick it. I still need to fix up this resolution thing. But I'm wondering, whether I could use this format of a search box, a list, as kind of the basis for the new settings as well. Because you could imagine that this could just be what you see by default, but with maybe some extra stuff either side. Just say, you know, open up the settings window, well, switch view basically. And potentially you could have a little edit icon at the end. Which takes the snippet into a mode where you can edit it rather than pick it. That could work. The alternative mode is to go back to something more classic like this, where we have snippets as a list, and then the detail is whichever one you've picked. And then you just update it. And you're done. You can see here, we do have a search box. I mean, this is all a mess at the moment in the GTK thing. And then some settings. Which is all a bit constrained. It would be nice to have all these just in a simple page where you just update them. And then we've got import and export, which could be well, the import could certainly be hidden. You rarely do a hidden. They rarely do an import. But you might export it manually occasionally. And maybe that export could work on what you've got either selected. Have searched. I don't know. I think maybe what I should do. I'm going to start with something more like this. See how it goes. I can always change it Okay, so we're going to need to make some changes here. So let's go to the app. Oh, I'm in the app. There we are. Do we want to keep those things available for later? Maybe. I might just stick them in the global. Might be useful. Okay. But let's gonna have to build this out now. So first thing we want is something that says, hang on a minute, there's no snippets. Maybe like a welcome page, as such, a welcome screen. So yeah, let's do that. How does this work and how do I get to my I don't use destruction mode. Oh, there we go. I can do that. That's cool. That was just Alt 1 to get the projects up. Okay. What I'm gonna do here is gonna create a new little folder here. And I'll just call that components. And then in here, we're going to create a new Svelte component and we'll call that welcome. Yes. What should we do here then? Let's just stick in some we'll just do some simple Hello World stuff at the moment. We'll do that, and then we'll do something like then we will do something like some sort of well, let's start with that. Get that into here. There we go. I think I'll just style this up here, but I might eventually migrate some of this. Something else, we'll see. So we'll do actually, do I want to make this a bit more of a flex thing? But we don't need to, at the moment. Everything can just be aligned center, I think. I could. Let's do I could put a wrap around it. Actually, if I do yeah, if I don't have a hook for it, then how am I going to do the flex box thing? Well, it's not flex box anymore, is it? Or do I want to do grid? No. No. Flex should be fine. Okay, what I'll do is I'll see if I can do that and then find a way. Can I just do body? Would that work here? Doesn't complain. It's not working though. Maybe H1 might be good then. Because you don't really want an H1 and a div. I mean, I could do that. Let's do, oh, it's going to be, I'll still need to do. Okay, I think I need to brush up on my flex stuff. I've not done that for like over a year now. Because I'm not doing the right thing here. Go here. And then I don't want that. I want. CSS, flexbox, direction. So I've picked the wrong thing already. Cross axis. Right, so what I'm going to have to do, I've been applying stuff to the wrong place, so I'm just going to switch that up in a minute, but I do need to do a crash course in Flex because I haven't touched it in a long time. I don't, at the moment I don't need this stuff, but okay. So, all right, so I believe that means I can just do. So if I did that, I wouldn't make much of a difference. But if I do, oops, that in theory, right. Why didn't that do what I expected there? I read the wrong thing there? Main axis, okay. Right, so I shouldn't be doing that. Cross axis is what I need. There go. Right. Yes, it's hard. It's one of the things about the way they've named things. Just kind of have to get into your mindset as to what they are. So anyway, So this gives us the basis here. So I can do something like I wonder if I can do, I want to see what the scope is of this stuff. So for a second, I'm just going to comment out those two things and see if I can actually, can I do that and what happens when I do? Yeah, okay. I wonder if there's something I can use. Anyway, for safety, I'll just stick to doing a wrapper. It might be easier. And maybe I'll just rename it later if I want to. So, and then maybe we would do something like nice to have a little box. Let's rough it out here. So we'll have something like actually, this could be one thing is having maybe a button. Let's see if I can actually do that with a button. And what we'll have in it. Just add snippet. And then we'll have to style that up. If I made it a div, it would be easier to start to change things, but be nice to have like a little icon on it. So maybe, I wonder, is there a, I wonder if there's like a svelte font. Awesome. Okay. Okay, your thing then. Okay, that looks all right. Okay, we'll give that a go. Check actually something on the package there. Is it all dev? Dependencies, yes, good. Okay. I want that. Okay. And then in here. What is it I'm doing again? Just an import of just Svelte dev. Svelte-awesome, isn't it? Yeah, icon. Svelte-awesome. And then the actual icon I want from Svelte-awesome icons. Now I've got to work out what I want. So I want, have they got a link to it there? Haven't they? So I want something like at plus. Okay. I wonder what that's like. Try that. Actually, I want to use just standardize on that feather in here. Ah. Stop it. It's felt awesome. I'm having a real bad day with typing. Yeah. Right, and then, well, this is gonna be hard, but we'll stick an icon in here. And what's the syntax? Data. Don't even know what plus square looks like, but we'll find out in a sec. Right, hold on. Now I'm sure I can do that, can't I? Yes. Right, this is going to be hard. But we'll at least maybe see. There we go. Okay. Maybe I will just make this a div, actually. Scale equals. Let's do, well, just do make it nice and big. And then I'm going to switch this to a container. And we'll call it what we're going to call this. Well, actually, I can just do content for the moment, and it'll probably do its own flex thing again. Yeah, that's cool. Don't mind that. Let's do something like do something like now it's opacity. percentage or point? Let's try that. Yeah. Okay, so let's do that. In fact, I'd probably want that to be dim, but not the text. Oh, that's interesting. Why did that not work? Why can't I give that a class? What is it? What else does class allow? It's not doing expected there. So what can I do to get that to it's a pain, it doesn't work like that. Wish you did. This will work. No, no difference. Didn't think it would, but it's worth a go. It's interesting that I can add opacity. At the top level, but not to it. Yeah, see, that's better. Okay. Do there's a new style thing that I haven't looked at for Svelte. Let's have a quick look at that. Okay. Right, I think don't want to muck about too much with this. This is only exploratory at the moment, but think. Problem is, I can't use that on an icon. I have to wrap it. So what I might do then is where's the one is props. Save the thing still. No, I want it. Okay. Okay, I might use that. So what I'm going to do, is in this large icon. Actually, it shouldn't really be called a large icon. Let's call it like a button. I think we'll do the whole thing. And we will change this to icon button, and we will set icon opacity. Actually, no, we won't. What we'll do is we will give it an extra class of dim. We will is a sped up way to one or two. Sorry, I meant two or three. Right. Do that. Why is that complaining? Right, it's dollar, dollar. So we are going to use that, and then here we're going to have some fun, aren't we? That's not going to work. So but is there like a question I'm missing? Square question. No, I'd probably just question on its own. I'll do that. This is just going to be like a little thing here. So I do like class to be first, so. Do that. So we're going to have an icon, blah blah blah. Switch that to icon. Slot. And we'll just steal that. Just for fun. This might clash, I don't know. The props, don't know if that'd work or not, we'll see in a sec. Okay, so we have div wrapper content to get the flexi stuff there. We've got props coming in to that, so that should get the dim thing, which I'm going to make global in a second. And then icon gets passed in. It's either going to be a question mark or whatever gets set there. And then we've got some slot content. So that's the slot. We're going to have class equals dim, icon blah. Let's make that global. Got global open, I have. So let's see what that does. Okay. I didn't want to do that dim for all of it again. Let's make it explicit then. Those parts because they're not really what I want anyway. We will do that. I was just wondering whether I could actually just use a stop it. Finish your words, Ian. I was going to see, wonder whether I should just have a, like a dim icon and just use a global. But okay, so icon class. Dim. There we go. That's better. Yeah, and the reason why that was not using flex on that is because the icon didn't have, didn't kind of belong to the body. You have to do some interesting things. You could basically make that a svelte fragment and stuff like that. But anyway, that's something else. But by putting the div in, we've put it into the actual, into the body of the div. The DOM. Anyway, I've got to go. I'm a bit late now. But that is a start for a very simple new GUI for it. And you can imagine we can now make that a hit target to add something, and we can make it selectable and stuff as well. And then it will switch to a page where you add your first snippet. I'll change all the style of those later. But cool. Anyway, right. Gotta go. So until next time, thanks for watching, and you take care.